I don't know. One thing I always want to ask people when I get there before the show is, what does Heilung mean to you, or what is the Heilung experience so far? And for me, I think the Heilung experience is the first time I listened to them a year ago when, you know, I was like, what in the world is this weird throat singing, blood covered people? And it wasn't 30 minutes that my roommates showed up and I was on the table like chanting along with them. And they were like, what happened? And they just heard this loud, like, throat singing cult music in my house. And I think that's what Heilung became to me, is this weird band that wasn't just a weird band, it like connected to me on a deeper level. So to see them live, you know, I'm curious to see what that's going to be, you know, to see how that experience changes from actually experiencing it. I mean, they call it a ritual for a reason, so I think that's definitely going to mean something. What you think makes Heilung special?
You know, for me, it helps me, I don't know, it's like it was this call to like connect with my roots, and it speaks to something very deep inside, and that's the only real description I can give. It's just something very deep and sort of.
I can't even explain. When people ask me what Heilung is, I'm like, I can't really explain it. You just have to listen.
They make it inclusive. They make it all inclusive for all cultures and everything.
Yeah, I think one of the most powerful things, the first image they shared, it was like people in LA or whatever, and it was mostly Native American people. Yeah, I'm like, that's so awesome, you know? Literally just got back from my trip to Chicago. The whole way back, I was thinking about Heilung and how it was seeing them live. First and foremost, hope you enjoyed the video. I had a lot of fun making it. It was a great trip. But what I really took away is that you definitely need to see them. Is the biggest thing is that was one of the most mesmerizing experiences I've ever went through in a live show. A little background to me is that I do photography, freelance photography, and I've done concerts, so I've been backstage, I've been in the front taking pictures, I've been in the, you know, front row, I've been, you know, right next to the bass and all these things, and so I've become a little, I guess, jaded to concerts and live events. You know, I don't have as much fun as I used to. The excitement has died down, and right when they started the show, I knew this was something different. I knew that this was something that everyone needed to experience. I mean, they came out, they dusted sage over everything and cleansed everything. They, you know, and then the procession came out of all the participants. And I think that was the weirdest thing is, you know, people say it's not, they actually say it's not a concert, it's a ritual. And I would say, you know, the people, the band members aren't band members, they're participants in the ritual. They are, you know, sorcerers, you know, the lead male singer, I call him the priest. And then you have the lead female singer, which I would call the priestess. You know, I wouldn't call them even singers, because they really were, you know, performing a ritual. And it's almost like, you know, they had one band member who used the sage to cleanse everything. You know, they didn't actually have like an active role in the concert itself. They were almost like this mischievous figure that just kind of went around, banged a few drums and got everyone hyped up. And it was weird because it's like they weren't people up there. They were, you know, these beings, these creatures, you know, these spirits. And the whole thing became this like unraveling the, you know, they summoned the gods, they summoned the spirits, they summoned the folk. And, you know, they released the spirits into the world around us. And then, you know, at the end, they ended it. You know, the ritual was over. They closed the circle. They closed the ritual. And there was no speaking. There was no, thanks for coming out tonight. You know, there was nothing like that. It was just the ritual. They did not break character. Not once did they break character. And I think that is the most amazing thing. I mean, there is nudity in the show, if you don't know that. But it isn't about the nudity. It's just, you know, the primalness of it. And, you know, kudos to the performer because, I mean, she's in the middle of 2,000 people topless. And, you know, of course, you have everyone recording her, and she did not break character. She was in a trance looking dead forward the whole time. And then once the ritual was complete, you know, she released her hair and just started going crazy and, like, they never broke character. And I mean, I wouldn't even call it character. I would call it a trance. They would call it this religious, you know, moment. And I mean, I can't say enough about this show. It was so good. Anyone who was there last night, you know how cramped it was. And they started 40 minutes late. And I don't think it was Heilung's fault. I think it was the venue's fault. You know, they definitely overbooked. And I mean, 2,000 people, you saw the video of how long the line was. And it was crazy how many people came out for this and how many different people came out for this too. So again, I hope you enjoyed the start of this video. That's definitely what I wanted you to see, is kind of my journey and also the experience of watching Heilung perform. Hopefully I'll be doing another video kind of covering more, but I just wanted you to see kind of my more processed reaction after driving for 6 hours. But last night I was so spellbound that I really couldn't even talk. But yeah, I'll be definitely doing another video on this here soon, but I just wanted to make sure I talked about it a little bit. It's good to be back. It was a great trip. Heilung was amazing, and I can't wait to see him again the next time they come around to America. But until next time, pagans, Skal.